got a bug walking from point A to point B. The bug can only walk on any single segment once, so no backtracking for our bug. And all these little segments with arrows, the bug can only go in the direction of the arrow, so the bug can go this way along this segment, this way along that segment. It can go either way or along these segments that have no arrows at all. The question, of course, is how many ways can the bug get from point A to point B? Now, what makes this really hard are these back arrows, because check this out, the bug can go out, and then back, and then forward, and then back, forward, on down, all the way up. Bug can go kind of all over the place. There's lots of things the bug can do. So what I'm going to focus on, what I want to focus on here is what the bug can't do. Because I want to look at the restrictions. What are the real restrictive points for the bug? And maybe that'll help me count, help me organize my counting. Because there's just tons and tons of stuff I can do here, tons of places the bugs can go. So if we focus on what the bug can't do, maybe we'll be able to count. Things that the bug can't do. Once the bug has left A, it can't go back to A. We can't backtrack along these arrows. So once the bug gets out to this level, the bug can't go back to A. Now once the bug goes to the next level, the bug can go back, right? Because it can go here, and go up, and then back, and then up. So this is not a restrictive point for the bug. The bug can come out here, and then backtrack. Now let's check out the next level. If we go up the next level, the bug gets to this level, bug can't backtrack. The bug can't go back along any of these four segments, so once the bug gets to this level right here, the bug can't go back. I'm going to call that level X. I'm going to focus on this level first. I'm going to focus right here, and I'm going to think about the first time the bug gets to any one of these points. Once the bug gets to this point, the bug's committed. The bug's got to go that way. It may be able to go that way and come backwards, like it could go forward here and then come back to that level and then go forward, but it can't go behind that level. So what I'm going to think about is, how many ways can the bug get to level X for the first time at this point right here? So I'm looking at getting to this point as the first time the bug gets to this level at all. And let's see, we can go straight along the bottom. The bug can go straight down here along the bottom. It can start along the bottom, switch up to the top, come back to the bottom. So those are the only two ways the bug can get here from A to be the first time that the bug gets to level X, by starting off going down. Let's go down the whole way, go down, go up, and then come back down. Now, let's take a look. There are other ways going up. So we go up first, and then come down and go to that point. We can go up and come down through here to that point, or we can go up and then backtrack through the back arrow and get to that point. So there are five ways total, two down, three up, that the bug can go from A and get to this point, and that's the first time the bug ever gets to level X. So by symmetry, we're going to have five ways to get up here as well. Now let's look at these two points in here. We have pretty much the same thing. Bug can go straight along the bottom, bug can go down, goes across to the other side, and then come back down. So there are two ways the bug can start off going down and end up here as the first time the bug gets to level X. Or the bug can go up and then down through, up, cut through and around, or the bug can go up and come backtrack the arrow and then get out there. So once again, there are five ways to get right here, and by symmetry there are five ways to get right here. And again, this is the counting the number of ways to get there for the first time. This will be the first time that the bug gets to level X at this point. There are five ways. Now once the bug has gotten here, the bug's committed, it's heading in that direction, it can't ever backtrack behind level X. So where's the next restrictive point? Now the bug can go forward from here and then end up going backwards up here, so this isn't a restrictive point. But this is, right here. We'll call that level Y. Once the bug gets to Y, the bug can't go back. So the bug can't get back to level X, can't even get back to here. So now I'm going to count the number of ways we can get from here out to here. Now first I'm going to look at going from this bottom dot to this bottom dot. Well, there are four branches that the bug could go forward on here to get off of level X and head towards level Y. Go there, there, and go all the way up, and then come all the way back down, up, and then back down. Notice that the bug can't use this back arrow and still get to this point as the first time it gets to level Y. Again, I'm looking at the first time it gets to level Y. I want the bug going straight there. I don't want the bug going here and then wiggling its way down. I'm looking for the first time it gets to level Y, it gets right there. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 ways to do that, because the bug can't go up and then backtrack. Now it's stuck. Once it's gone up here, if it backtracks, it's going to have to repeat a segment. We can't do that. So there's 4 ways to get from here to here, where that's the first time we get to level Y. And same thing here. We've got, if the bug starts here and it's trying to get there is the first time it gets to level Y, there's 2 choices down here it could cross, 2 choices up here. It can go down and across, up and across, up and across. There's 4 more. And then same thing up. Now, up here we have something a little bit different. First of all, we have the same thing in that it can go across any of these 4. It can go across, 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 and straight down to Y. So that's 4 ways. But there's something else the bug can do. The bug can go up and then back and then across. So the bug can start here. There's 2 choices for it going across here. And then it can backtrack. And then it's got 2 more choices for going across that way. So that gives us 4 more options that the bug can do. So the bug starting from here has 4 options going direct to this point, where it just goes direct across and then straight to the point, direct across, straight to the point. But then there are 4 more options where the bug chooses one of these 2 to cross up here, and then cuts back, and then chooses one of these 2 to go across and through. So there's 8 ways from this point to this point. And same reasoning, there'll be 8 ways from this point to this point. And of course, there are 5 ways to each one of these. So the total number of ways is 5 times this entire sum. Whew. 4 and 8 is 12. 4 and 8 is another 12. That's 24. So this is 120 ways to get to this point where this is the first place, this is the first time the bug gets to level Y. And we can go through the exact same argument to get 120 for each of these other points. It's precisely the same argument. So for each of these points, the number of ways the bug can get to level Y for the first time at that point is 120. Now we're almost there. We've gotten all the way to here. We've got to get from here off to the end. So I'm going to get from here to B. How many ways are there to get from here to B? Well, the bug can go straight. That's 1. It can go across and then down. That's 2. We can go up, back down, and then to B. We can go up and all the way across. That's 4. We can go up. Well, we can't cut back. So it looks like there are just 4. But there were 5 back here. That should make us a little uncomfortable. Make us a little uncomfortable. Make us think maybe there should be 5. There were 5 to get to this level. It seems like there might be 5 to finish off. Let's check again. Now, 1 right along the bottom. Let's start along the bottom. Ah, we could have cut back here. So always think, like, if you get something that's a little bit different than what you saw before, go back and think, did I miss something? We missed something here. Go straight along the bottom, that's 1. Along the bottom, across and down, that's 2. Along the bottom, cut back, and then through, that's 3. All the way up, all the way back down, and finish, that's 4. All the way up and then across the top. That's 5. So there are 5 ways to get from here to there. Now, of course, so that's 5 times 120 ways to finish. That's 600 from this point. And the same thing is going to be true from this point. It's going to be this, basically the same set. Along the bottom, down and then up, down and then backtrack, and then up across. That's 3. Across the top, up to the top, back down to the bottom. That gives us a total of 5. So there are going to be 600 from there as well. There are going to be 600 total from here and 600 total from here because these are symmetric to these. So my total ways to get to B is going to be 600 times 4, which is 2,400. Not only is it one of our choices, but it's the largest of the choices, so we can be extra confident that we are done.